touchdown to first half.
It's over. Boston College wins
all the way.
It's a touchdown for Miami.
Looking for the end zone. Touchdown. Torrey Holt. Johnson's there. Touchdown.
And there's Orange in the end zone.
One of the biggest plays in Duke history.
A moment of magic.
I'm Jeff Fischel. Notre Dame starts its 5 ACC games a year.
Touchdown to first half.
It's over. Boston College wins
all the way.
It's a touchdown for Miami.
Looking for the end zone. Touchdown. Torrey Holt. Johnson's there. Touchdown.
And there's Orange in the end zone.
One of the biggest plays in Duke history.
A moment of magic.
I'm Jeff Fischel. Notre Dame starts its 5 ACC games a year next season. Did you know the ACC school it has played the most is Pitt? They've met 66 times. This will be the first year they meet with Pitt repping the conference. For the teams we think of as classic ACC, the matchup we've seen the most for the Fighting Irish is Georgia Tech. And you only have to go back 7 years for a good one, 2006. Notre Dame led by Brady Quinn. The year before, he finished 4th in the Heisman. Georgia Tech led by Megatron, Calvin Johnson. But despite those offensive superstars, this one was mostly dominated by defense. Remember, during Throwback, I'll be tweeting from the ACCDN Twitter account, so check that out while you watch for some great nuggets, storylines, and links about these teams. So here you go, 2006, Notre Dame visiting Georgia Tech. Brent Musburger, Kirk Herbstreit, and Bob Davey have the call. This is ACC Throwback here on the ACC Digital Network, brought to you by Ruby Tuesday.
To so many, this is what college football means, what it needs. The Fighting Irish, near the top of every poll, on the tip of every tongue, the thirst for the bygone glory of the game. Welcome to the new good old days. Only 1 year of the Weiss era in the books, and Notre Dame is number 2 in the preseason rankings. Heisman hopeful Brady Quinn is poised to run his coach's masterful system all the way to a national title. This evening, the Irish open their 2006 campaign against explosive Reggie Ball and the rambling wreck of Georgia Tech. It's Saturday night, and ESPN on ABC is proud to bring you the very best in college football in prime time, starting right now.
Charlie Weiss is a graduate of Notre Dame. In 1974, that was his freshman year. And as a freshman, Notre Dame opened its season against Georgia Tech and won 31-7. Now as a head coach, he comes to the sideline having won the coin flip, as he normally does. He will receive. He'll want the ball to start this game against the Georgia Tech defense. Chan Gailey on the other side, the fifth season here, 4 straight 7-win seasons. And as Bob Daly told you, last year, huge upsets against Auburn and Miami. Underway in Atlanta. And it's fielded on the 12 by the freshman. Huge gap. He's got some speed. Down at the 45-yard line where the Irish will have a first and 10. And Kirk, they bring out their great quarterback, Brady Quinn.
Well, Brent, the last thing you want to do early in a game is give Brady Quinn great field position, almost up to midfield. Brady's making his 34th career start. What makes this guy, in my mind, the number one prospect for the NFL is his experience.
And Bob and Kirk, a homecoming for the tailback, number 3, Darius Walker. Charlie Weiss always scripts the game, and he gives the Atlanta youngster the first call, and he bangs his way to the 48-yard line. Now, folks, our starting lineups presented by City. So many stories, but let's focus on this one. Sam Young is the first freshman to start the opening game of the season for the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame. He's 6'8", number 74. You see him right there as he brings him out. And they give him tight end coverage over there with John Carlson to help him on that side. They know he'll be tested. Play fake, and here's Quinn's first pass of the game. They put it in Walker's hand, short of the first down as he comes across midfield. Three receivers to the left, and Quinn moves the pocket in that direction, fires hard and incomplete, and very good coverage by Kenny Scott.
Guys, that is incredibly, incredibly huge for this Georgia Tech team. In the first series, at home as an underdog, with everybody expecting Notre Dame and Charlie Weiss and Brady Quinn to put up points tonight, to get a stop and to force a punt, especially after the big return, is huge for the confidence of this team.
Now, a brand new play caller, Patrick Nix, has taken over for head coach Chan Gator. We're going to ask Bob about that right after we see this offensive lineup. On first down, he puts it in the hands of the big fella. Remember now, Bob Davey has told you, Calvin Johnson, and there's his first catch. Now, let's take a look at this starting lineup presented by City. Underrated, overlooked, number 22, Shachard Tashard Choice. Remember now, recruited by Bob Stoops at Oklahoma, was behind Adrian Peterson, mother became injured, moved back to Georgia, played last year. He's a good-looking ball control running back. He'll show you a little cut in the hole. Here's his first carry. Got the daylight. Barges upfield. And with a nice run on his first carry. Now the City Notre Dame defense. Remember, they were embarrassed last year in the Fiesta Bowl. Something to prove. And Travis Thomas was moved in the spring from running back to linebacker to try and give this Irish defense a little more speed. Now, Bob, go ahead and tell us about Patrick Nix calling plays. He's probably bucked right straight here for a first down.
I think it helps Georgia Tech. I think it helps Reggie Ball. Patrick Nix has been his quarterback coach for 4 years. They have a great relationship, Brent, a great trust.
Reggie goes right straight ahead for the first down. He would have got a lot of carries out there in Norman. Now, Rashawn Grant will give him a blow. Number three from the gun, option look. Here comes Grant. Had enough time on a spinner across the 35-yard line. Well, also working with this is Lisa Salters. And Lisa, I know we had a long conversation with Coach about giving up the play calling responsibilities, didn't we?
That's right, Brent. We asked him what part of his lesser responsibilities did he enjoy the most, and he said, I don't enjoy any of it. In fact, he says, it's driving me crazy. I haven't gone to any of the offensive meetings, and I really wish that I could, but it's for the betterment of the team. I asked him right before kickoff, I said, Coach, how does this game feel any differently tonight? And he said, for lack of a better word, I feel empty, like I should be doing something, but I know that the offense is in good hands. I'm sure he's happy with the way things are going right now. Brent?
All right, Lisa, thanks a lot. Johnson breaks free, end zone ahead, pushed out of bounds. That was Tom Zivakowski saving the touchdown. Big number 21.
And he gets a great block, Brent, in the open field by McNeil, number 8, the receiver. They chop the block, and the strength of Calvin Johnson.
Great job by Chris Dunlop downfield as well, picking up blocks. These receivers from Georgia Tech and the active offensive line, these guys are committed up right now.
Choice is back as the running back. There's the fake. Johnson up in the air. Got a touchdown, Georgia Tech. Cannot stop number 21 on the fade when you throw the jump ball in the end zone. What a wide receiver. Bell, who struggled a year ago after a brilliant freshman campaign, tacks it on with his new holder, Durant Brooks, the punter, putting it down. And let's take a look at this. What a fade receiver here, Bob.
And Kirk, you and I are not surprised. We've seen this a lot. When they say he has a 45-inch vertical jump at 6'5", that makes it pretty simple. Throw the ball up in the air to Calvin Johnson, number 21.
Time running, 1:15. Weiss in a bit of a hurry up. And as a coach, you go back to his days with the New England Patriots in the NFL. That's the last time he's been shut out in the first half. Quinn juggled, should have been caught, comes back after it and got it. at the 20-yard line. A ricochet, and tight end John Carlson went back and caught it. What a play.
You know, there's so much talk about this offense not having Anthony Fasano. And talking to Brady Quinn, he said, I'll tell you, John Carlson can catch the football along with Marcus Freeman. And that time, great concentration. He got his hands underneath, and that is a catch, a big catch for the Irish.
There's a timeout used by the Irish right here. We're just inside of 1 minute. First down and 5 yards after the penalty. Time, Samardzija. Second down.
You notice the amount of time that he had that time? That time he's able to sit back in the pocket, look at the defense. The play took a long time to develop. And actually, the ball was thrown pretty well there.
Kirk, one thing, when you're a blitzing defense and you blitz linebackers up the field so much, you get tired on defense.
Sure.
And right now, Georgia Tech looks a little tired to me. Great opportunity for Notre Dame just to try to get something on the board here.
Here's Walker. Straight ahead for a first down and goal. Keep an eye on that clock. It'll stop with the first down. This is first and goal now for the Irish. They have one timeout left.
And if I'm Georgia Tech, I call timeout on defense because I think Georgia Tech is tired right now. Watch the arm tackling right there. Darius Walker almost scored. Use a timeout for your defense right now. Re-energize them if I'm Georgia Tech.
This is the 13th play of this drive, so it's no wonder right now. Their hands are on their hips and they're gassed.
Kenny Scott takes Samardzija. They're going to run to the left side. Not going to make it.
Notre Dame with no timeouts.
Backfield empty. Working with 16 seconds. Quarterback draw. Brady Quinn dives. End zone. Brady Quinn.
That was a great call, but a risky call with no timeouts and second and goal at the five. The half is over if he doesn't score. But a big, big drive for the Irish.
Big drive, and because it worked, it's easy to say gutsy call and a great call to get 7 points out of that drive. 14 plays. Huge, huge play. And a surprise.
Joya tacks on the extra point. Folks, we're going to have a whale of a second half here at Atlanta.
You go with the quarterback draw. He gets a great block from John Sullivan and the right guard, Bob Morton, scores on the quarterback draw.
Brady Quinn on this drive showing it's not just his arm. This is the second time he's had to use his feet. And I know John Tenuta, defensive coordinator, things have gone too well for him to see his defense give up that big a drive. And that can change the momentum and complexion of this game on that series.
See the first five possessions and what they did on that last one.
But you go back to that last one, 14 plays, 80 yards, and a touchdown. You get it to 10-7. As miserable as things went in the first half, you hold Georgia Tech to three and out. You get the ball back. Momentum has changed. This possession, pivotal for both teams.
30 yards of penalties against Notre Dame tonight. There's that quick drop. And here's Raymond McKnight up against a linebacker who slashed over there on him. That was Gary Guyton. Coming over out of bounds, so that short drops it against a fierce rush.
Big mistake right here by Kenny Scott, the experienced corner. Right there, he comes inside, gives up contain, and allows Raymond McKnight to the outside. Good block right there by Marcus Freeman, the tight end.
Second down and 7. Toss play, Walker. First down, Notre Dame.
Number 3, Darius Walker on the carry.
This is more like Notre Dame. You're going to take a good look here at the center. John Sullivan coming around. The All-American left tackle Ryan Harris coming around, getting upfield and giving their running back for one of the few times tonight a little bit of room to work with. But if you notice here, Georgia Tech, not so much, they're not as aggressive as they were in the first half, pinning their ears back, and it's because right now Notre Dame's mixing it up, keeping them a little bit more on their heels.
First down and 10. Walker to daylight again, first down. And the youngster who grew up right here in this area was recruited by Georgia and Georgia Tech, elected to go to Notre Dame, running strong here.
When a team moves a lot up front, you go to the outside zone and you just push them in whatever direction they want to go, and you put the ball into the hands of a nifty running back who has great vision, who's elusive, and let him make the read and bounce off of the blocks. A lot of movement, push him on his outside zone, and let your back do the work.
Now the fullback pounding away, swapping. I think we see here, Kirk and Bob, I think you would both agree, obviously the Irish coaches have said, we're going to start pounding at him. We're going to start running at him.
But I think the key is, can this guy right here, who has held to 7 points in the first half, stay patient and keep doing this?
And pass protection would be a huge question for a freshman, and they go empty anyway out of the backfield. Pressure. Quinn steps away from it, fires for a first down. Rayma McKnight.
Wow. Any question about Brady Quinn's arm strength? And think of the big plays in this game. Even though Brady Quinn has struggled, go back to the big third down when he scrambled for 16 yards in the first half. And how about right here, thread the needle between Michael Hall and Jahari Ward-Daniels for the big first down to Raymond McKnight.
Nice job, too, by the offensive line, pushing that defensive line in to give him the time.
He had a good picture of Darius Walker, who's back on the field and carrying. Battling to the 26-yard line, and now it'll be second down as Vance Walker seeing some playing time. Makes a stop.
And again, the huge offensive line, big size advantage over Georgia Tech's defensive line. Georgia Tech moving a lot up front. Fatigue on defense, if I'm a Georgia Tech coach or player right now, is my biggest concern.
The Irish have a 4-minute edge in possession time, keeping this defense on the field. Here's Samardzija. Turns it into a good gain, and another Notre Dame first and 10 inside the 20-yard line. There's the young man who signed a baseball contract with the Chicago Cubs. Jeff Samardzija worked in the minor leagues. They said that had he been willing to leave baseball, somebody might have drafted him in the first round. They knew he was coming back to play football.
That's actually a play that's designed and called as a run. But the relationship between the quarterback, Quinn, and the receiver, Samardzija, they checked to that on their own without the rest of the offense knowing and picked up a first down.
They fake Walker, goes in zone, incomplete. Second down and 10, Irish threatening. Fade, corner, out of bounds, incomplete. Pat Clark was the defender.
Coming into this football game, the one guy that I was concerned about the most for Georgia Tech secondary is this guy right here, Pat Clark. When you think about it, it's really unbelievable. He was a receiver last year, caught several passes in the last game of the year down in Miami. Now he's starting at corner, and I think really competing, and you saw it on that play right there.
Here's your third down. The fullback to protect. Dances right, can't find a man open. And he is punched out of bounds. That's a penalty. Phillip Wheeler draws the flag, and that is a huge penalty against the Georgia Tech defense.
And Brent, I don't know if it's necessarily late, but it's helmet to helmet on Phillip Wheeler. Came high on Brady Quinn.
See Phillip Wheeler uses that helmet as a weapon and a blow to the head right there. That rule has always been a part of college football, really started to be reinforced last year. He did use that helmet as a weapon.
In the third.
First and goal from the eight.
The toss to Walker, stretched to the left. There was a penalty flag. I believe the umpire threw it. By the umpire, he had it.
Post, number 50 on the offense. 10-yard penalty, repeat each down.
Santucci, left guard. So that ball is going to be brought back in the 17 and 18-yard line here. First down and goal still for Weiss and the Irish. And their only touchdown in this game is a quarterback draw. And remember that Brady Quinn did not throw a touchdown pass against Ohio State in the Fiesta Bowl. That broke that string of 16 consecutive games. Draw play, Walker. Stop at the 15-yard line.
I thought on this play, it looked like Darius Walker had a cutback possibility right there. It looked like he could have cut back and squirted it out of there.
That's pretty tight if it is. I'm glad I wasn't running the ball there. It closed, if there was a cutback, it closed pretty quick. This defense has changed their tune, and I think it goes back to the call a couple plays ago on Philip Wheeler. Their energy is back.
Second and goal, drops it off, the screen, here's Walker, touchdown, penalty flag. Downfield blocking on the screen and penalty flag was thrown at the back of the end zone. Illegal block by the Irish.
Tight end that time, John Carlson, got downfield. He was actually in pretty
illegal
good position.
Block in the back. Number 89 on the offense. That penalty is assessed 10 yards from the spot of the foul, and we will repeat second down.
Carlson was in very good position downfield on Roberson, a safety, but as Walker catches the ball and starts to make some moves, he adjusts to Roberson. He's great right there, but right now the ball carrier goes right by him, and that little push in the back was a great call by the official to bring that back.
And they bring it back to the 13-yard line. Still second down and goal, remember. Draw, Walker again, sprinting left, looking for the angle. Got Scott on him, dives for the pylon. Touchdown. Notre Dame leads for the first time this season.
Guys, this is exactly why Darius Walker is a perfect fit and a great complement to Brady Quinn in the passing game. The draws, the screens, this is Darius Walker in a nutshell. Keep in mind, he came back after sustaining the big hit to finish his drive off. Again, 14 plays and 7 points for the Irish. Same as the last drive. That's two drives in a row, 14 plays for Notre Dame.
From the fans, they'll be over at Athens. They're going to throw out the first pitch when the Dogs open their baseball season next spring. Here's a long pass for Raymond McKnight. McKnight got it. 21-yard line. Just looking long ball of the night by number 10. The Irish with a second down. Here's Walker. dances in the middle inside the 20. This is going to be third and a big play coming up for this Georgia Tech defense.
I tell you what,
you made the point, they'd love to get him into a field goal situation.
No question, Brent. Hold him to a field goal. How about this move right here by Darius Walker? Right there. Beats Phillip Willer. They had penetration in the backfield just to get that back to the line of scrimmage. But huge play right here on 3rd and 7.
Darius Walker's off. The freshman, number 25, the tailback in motion. Raina McKnight drops it inside the 10-yard line, and that brings up a field goal situation. And that is all the Georgia Tech could ask for. And he just said, come on, Ray. As he comes off the field, you can read Coach Weiss's lips. Now, remember, Joya missed a 42-yarder back in the second quarter. This is a 36-yarder. Samarja the holder. Missed again. It's a four-point game.
And I'll tell you what, go back to the drop by Raymond McKnight on third down, a sure first down. Huge, huge break for Georgia Tech right here.
Second down and 10. Lowe picks it up, buried at midfield. Running over him is Travis Thomas, the two-way player here tonight.
26, Travis Thomas.
Here we go now. Third down, ladies and gentlemen, at 15, 6:28. They'll bring the action to you. In trouble. Going down. The Irish defense with Maurice Crum, number 40, leading the assault that time.
The last two plays, Notre Dame decided to instead of sitting back, Rick Minner decided to bring pressure. And that was a good call. Even though it's third and long, instead of dropping back with seven or eight, they decide to bring Crum from the outside, bring some linebackers, and try to force Reggie Ball to make a play.
And close at the end of this play, if the whistle blow late hit right there on the quarterback, very close right there, could have been a personal foul on Notre Dame.
From behind Brooks, the punter. Zivakowski back inside the 10. Swings free, and they clean up on him at the 5-yard line. Dangerous, dangerous field position coming up for Brady Quinn. The toss to Darius Walker. Got daylight. Raina McKnight comes back to help him get downfield, and a huge, huge run for the young man whose family is over there in the stands tonight with the Irish fans. 19 yards, and Darius Walker's helped carry the load here.
I am impressed with Darius Walker, how tough he is. I can see now why he broke Herschel Walker's all-time touchdown record in the state of Georgia. 47 touchdowns, 3 state championships in the state of Georgia. This kid, to me, is the difference in this football game, Brent, right here. Darius Walker in the second inning.
Yeah, and that play right there is as big as it gets right now.
As you know, Charlie Weiss, you know he's an aggressive play caller. It'd be shocking if he does not decide to throw the football to pick up this first down.
Go back, Brady up. Great blocking job. Beautiful to Raymond McKnight. What a job by the offensive line. Tanuna brought pressure, and it was picked up gorgeously by that veteran offensive front. And the month of September doesn't get any easier. Penn State, Michigan, and South Bend. Up to East Lansing to Michigan State. Back home, Purdue. It's brutal. And the Irish have a target on them right now. And Thomas twisting did not get it.
Georgia Tech with no timeouts, but how amazing, and maybe the most critical play in the game, you hand the ball to a tailback who started the game, Brent, as a linebacker.
This is rather interesting because if you look at that picture, he's going to go for it. Kirk, go ahead.
Earlier this week, I talked to Charlie Weiss about his nature to go for it, being aggressive. He said, we did a study in the NFL. He said, you know the two guys that were in the top three this last year? Bill Belichick, number one, and going for it, and Bill Parcells, number three, and going for it on fourth and one.
Travis Thomas is his running back. That is no easy yard there, too, as you look down. And Quinn over the top.
Boys, I'm going to tell you something. That third and nine call, electing to throw the ball and then going for it on fourth and one, that's why players that he recruits want to play for Charlie Weiss. The aggressive nature of the play calling, not only the scheme, but the aggressive nature. This game now is over.
And if you turn that football over right there, you may never live that one down.
The headline, how about survives? Anybody think of a better headline than that?
Perfect. You know the headline? One. In the end, all that matters is the W. This was a tough, hard-fought win for Notre Dame tonight.
14-10, our final score.
The Notre Dame defense double and even triple-teamed Calvin Johnson in the second half, though he finished with 111 yards receiving and the Yellow Jackets' only touchdown. In the second half, he had just two catches for 16 yards. Thanks for watching ACC Throwback, and if you were following the ACCDN on Twitter, I hope you enjoyed the extra knowledge I was dropping there. Next Thursday at 1 p.m., we'll have another ACC Throwback game. I'm Jeff Fischel.